March is a Mompreneur Month here on the Beat 92.5. And we've been, you know, bringing people in from different walks of life, different moms who are very career-oriented, doing wonderful things, but at the same time, finding a balance between business and a very, very busy family life. And I'm really excited because it's the first time that I meet our next guest in studio. Good morning, Priya Chopra.
Good morning, Sean. How are you?
I'm great. Thanks for coming in. You're amazing.
You're too nice.
President and founder of One Milk, Two Sugars, PR company. I mean, you know, it's everything, right? It's fashion, it's lifestyle, it's beauty. But not only are you the president and the founder, you've been doing this alone for, what, a better part of a decade, I think?
Yeah, a little more than a decade.
It's a lot of work. But you're a mom of three as well.
Yeah, three.
How old, dare I ask?
So, the first one, my daughter is 5.
Okay.
Jaya, her name is. My son is 3. His name is Kian. And then we had a surprise baby last year.
Gotta love the surprise baby.
April Fool's Day, I found out. No joke.
No,
that's not a joke. So yeah, surprise baby came along last year, and his name is Loic, and he is now going to be 4 months
old. Oh my gosh,
yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I know what you're going through, you know, with the baby at home who doesn't sleep. Oh, we have an 8-month-old who just refuses to sleep the night, and we have a 3.5-year-old. Thankfully, he sleeps, but, you know, he's got a lot of energy. He's a little boy in every sense of the word. So, you know, balancing this business that you've got and 3 kids, and I would imagine the nights are probably tough for you too, and we were just talking a bit off the air, and you know, you're not getting a whole lot of sleep.
Zero.
Before we get into sort of what you do with your business, how do you manage balancing that family life with, you know, being a really, really busy entrepreneur?
So I think I've learned along the way. You know, you kind of get the hang of it, like you were saying. No 2 kids are alike, or no 3 kids are alike. That's
the truth, yeah.
So I feel like this third baby has taken me for a ride a little bit. But I think 5 years ago when I had my daughter, my business wasn't in the same position that it is now. So I think that over the years, things have evolved and become more stable. And I've delegated and I've hired really strong people. It's been such a learning. And, you know, a lot of women think, it's like my biggest revelation, a lot of women think that they have to choose, you know, when they have a family or their career.
Mm-hmm.
When I had kids, that's how my business grew, ironically.
Interesting, isn't that
because
great?
Because I stopped doing things myself because I couldn't.
Right.
You know how it is.
Of course, absolutely. You just don't have the time. There's not enough hours in the day.
Yeah, I'm like asleep on the couch. I just can't keep my eyes open at 9 p.m. I'm like, that's it. My day's done. So
story of my life.
Yeah.
Big Friday night, 8:30 in bed reading a book.
Exactly. Exactly. So you just don't have the energy.
Right.
So I started to delegate and I started to hire people that I could trust and, you know, help me with the growing business, and that's how it came to be.
I think that's one of the toughest things too. You know, we all want to have, you know, ultimate 100% control over everything we do. And I would imagine when it's your own business, that feeling is even greater, right? So to be able to let go and delegate and trust the people around you, that's got to be a really, really tough thing to do.
It's really tough. And of course, like when it is your business, as you say, you take so much pride because you've gone through so much pain to put it all together and to build it up. So it is, I think it's also a question of putting in place certain procedures and testing certain things and, you know, loosening up as you go. So not kind of like loosening the reins all at once, but I think slowly but surely, you know, having earned the trust of the people and, you know, that are working for you and loosening up a bit as we went along.
I know I'm not supposed to ask you this, but how old are you? Because you don't, I mean, you look like you're 24, first
really?
Of all.
Oh, you're too kind. My great. I wanted to do my retouch before
coming
in. Oh,
yeah. Well, so did I. Didn't have time to do that.
I didn't. I swear I did.
Have you seen the bags under my eyes?
Well, we can relate on that.
Yeah.
I'm 37.
37.
Yeah.
Man, you've got a lot of experience behind you for somebody who's only 37. Congratulations on the new addition, albeit a surprise one.
Yeah.
And the other 2 beautiful kids and a blossoming business. I say blossoming. It's been around for so long, but it seems like it's so healthy and doing well. And
so
I think
much,
a really great example of what this month is all about, what I've been trying to do, Mompreneurs coming in and showing that you can have both. You know, you can have your cake and eat it too, and you can have all that wonderful stuff at home and be what you are on a daily basis at the office. So
I really encourage moms to follow their dreams. I mean, now's the time.
Absolutely. Priya Chopra, the president and founder of One Milk, Two Sugars. Thanks for coming in this morning.
Pleasure. Thanks.